Morning everybody, I am Dr. Amit Porwal, Member Scientific Committee. Today I am going to show a video of how to make a protective eye shield for the slit lamp so that we get protected against the aerosols from the patient when we are examining them. The things required to make an eye shield. Basically, you need a plastic sheet. You can use an A4 size file folder. You need a screwdriver, a scissor or a cutter to cut the hole to fix it to the slit lamp, a pen to mark the diameter of the hole, and this is standard packing tape which is available in the market. You can use the inner diameter of this packing tape to mark the hole and then cut it so that the shield can be put on the slit lamp. So now I'm going to show the video of how we dismantle the slit lamp and prepare the shield. This is a head slit model of the slit lamp. All the slit lamps have these attachments. You have to look at your own slit lamp attachments and can prepare the shield. So first, this is, take out the operation tonometer which is mounted on the slit lamp. Place it safely so that it doesn't get damaged. Then take a screwdriver. There is a screw here in the head slit slit lamp. You have to take out the screw by supporting it. So this is the way. You have to make sure that you are holding the eyepiece so that it doesn't fall down, and unscrew it properly. Throughout the procedure, make sure that you don't damage the attachment. Now this is the eyepiece which has been removed and has been placed safely on the table. So this is the eyepiece you have removed. Now there's another screw. You unscrew it. Make sure that you put some protective paper below this part of the slit lamp when you're unscrewing it. So now the screw is removed. When you remove the screw, this particular attachment is removed and there's a spring. You have to be very careful, don't lose it. And now this sheet what we have taken, this has to slide on this part of the slit lamp. So how we are going to make the measurement? What you can do is you can take the standard tape and roll and see it on the slit lamp whether it goes freely or no. If it goes freely and not much space is left, then that is the right diameter. If not, you can take out this particular part of the slit lamp. Once this is out, on the sheet, on this folder at the 1/3 inferior 2/3 junction, you can just keep it and mark, and you can take 1 cm more on either side. But in this particular slit lamp, hexagonal slit lamp, this tape is sliding over it, so we can use the inner diameter of this tape and place superior 1/3 and the inferior 2/3 junction. We need the superior part so that our eyes also are protected, superior part of the nose also is protected, and then you mark the inner diameter of this tape with the help of your marker. So you marked a circle. Now this is the diameter which has been marked. Now what you have to do is you have to cut this along this diameter and take out the central part. With the scissor you make a hole in the superior part, pierce the sheet. Once you have pierced, then cut the inner diameter of the sheet. So the inner diameter of this is supposed to be cut. You can use a scissor or a cutter, and once it is cut, you will see that the two film is out. Now you have a center hole. Now this you are supposed to mount on the slit lamp. How are you going to mount it? You just going to take the slit lamp very carefully. First you close the eyepiece what you used earlier. Make sure you don't touch any the front of the glass with your finger, because you don't want any fingerprints there. Once it is done, you take the shield and slide over. You have slided this protective shield on the slit lamp piece, and then you mount the slit lamp back where it was. And now you need to tighten the screw which you had taken out earlier. So now start tightening the screw. Throughout the procedure, make sure that your slit lamp is held properly. You should not hold it loose so that nothing falls, and don't touch the optics, and be careful because your equipment is expensive. You don't want to take any risk. Now the shield is mounted. Now the remaining part of the slit lamp which I had taken out, that is the operational tonometer mounter, that also. So now the spring which was taken out, this part is placed first. The spring is put inside, and then this screw is tightened. So now it is tightened. Now the operational tonometer is taken back and is put where it was before. Now we have mounted the shield, but you can see there's a gap over here. So this we need to close. Now how we close? We have the center circular part of the cut shield which we have taken, folded into two, And once you fold into two, the semicircle goes down and you can just stick it like this. Or what you can do is, you can cut this in the center with the help of a scissor. Once you have cut with the scissor, place the infill part of the circle below and you will be covering this gap. Take a tape and fix it so that the hemicircle is attached and you can just close this shield. Whatever opening is there is closed by the tape. So this is how we are going to seal now this. All the chances of any aerosol or droplet is being covered. This is the protection shield. It is very clear. You can use a transparent exhibit or any transparent folder. The reason behind that is, when you are using it now, if you want to do the apprehension interferometry or you want to do an eye examination, if you want to tell the patient to look at your ear, because it is a transparent sheet, patient can look through the sheet towards your ear and he will be fixing the primary gaze. Whenever the patient breathes or expires, any aerosol is there, this shield protects us. Even the patient coughs also, this shield protects us. What we can do is, how to clean this shield is, you can take a sterilium and clean the front surface of the shield with the help of sterilium and gauze piece, so that the sterility also is maintained. And if the shield becomes dirty, you can again prepare a new shield. This shield slightly should move because it helps in cleaning also. But this is the way you are going to prepare an eye shield. For any queries or doubt, you can always contact me. I'm available on my mobile number is 9974221111. It's an initiative by All India Ophthalmology Society Scientific Committee. Thank you.